What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the Thomas Gallery. Today we have, to date, the most intricate skull I've done yet, and this is of the shark. I didn't choose a specific shark, I just chose, you know, sharks in general. And sharks, for those who don't know, fall under the family Psyllac Eomorphia. Now, I looked it up. I forgot what it meant. I know morphia means to change, to shift, or something like that. So, well, like metamorphosis, you know. And sharks always been cool to me, you know. We all know the hysteria behind sharks and the water, mainly from the movie Jaws. Jaws is solely responsible for the fear that humans have about sharks. You know, even though by the numbers, there aren't that many shark attacks. Not as much as people would believe if you pay attention to the Hollywood propaganda and the media. If you pay attention to that, you would have thought there was a shark attack every 5 minutes, but not really. There really isn't. But that's just me. Anyway, I chose a shark because it's pretty cool, and sharks are very unique animals. They've been around for an extremely long time, and was a couple of things that are unusual about it. One, they've been around since before the dinosaurs. We have records of a giant shark called a megalodon, which means giant tooth or big tooth. Don meaning tooth, like orthodontist. Don meaning tooth. Mega meaning big, so big tooth. And they were much, much larger than the great white shark, which is the largest shark to date. And they've been around since before the dinosaurs. They're very, like, they're prehistoric. And from all of that, from the fossil records that are shown, they haven't changed much, which means that somewhere in their evolutionary track, they hit the jackpot, I should say. They were designed in a way where they're good. Now, of course, there's been some variation and stuff over those periods of time, but for the most part, from the records that we have, they haven't changed much. So that just goes to show you that some things work. If it ain't broke, don't fix it, kind of sort of. And what's also interesting about sharks is that they don't have the typical skeletal structure as other animals, whether it be aquatic animals or whether it be land animals. They don't have the quote-unquote regular skeleton for vertebrates. Their bodies are set up very, very different in the way that they, like, you know, most vertebrates have a spine and a rib cage. You know, well, sharks have spines, but they don't really have rib cages. And instead of having hard bone throughout their body, like most vertebrates do, hard bones inside their bodies, like most vertebrates do, their skeletal structure, quote unquote, is made up predominantly of cartilage. Excuse me. Now, for those who don't know, cartilage is that soft, squishy material, like what you call gristle. Like you eat a piece of chicken, you eat the gristle, that's the cartilage. Or your ear, like the soft parts of your ear. Like, that is cartilage. And their skeletal structure, and cartilage is simply, cartilage becomes bone. Just when cartilage hardens, it becomes bone. That's why when you look at an infant's skull, their skull is soft, and then as a baby gets older, the cartilage hardens into the skull, the bone. That's basically it. Cartilage is pretty much what hasn't hardened to turn into bone. And a shark's skeletal system, quotation marks, quote unquote skeletal system, is made up of cartilage. Now you have the skull, you have the skull of a shark, which is what I'm drawing. This is actually the skull of a shark. All right. So the skull of the shark is mainly where all of the bones are for the shark. Where they have like a bunch of like, they have like many rows of teeth. Like if you look at most animals, well, if you look at mammals, I should say mammals. Mammals have a certain amount of teeth that they have, that they grow, and it's a certain number that's not going any higher than that. Like humans have 32. Adult humans have 32 teeth. And it's one row on the top and bottom. Right? One row on the top and bottom. And we're not getting any more. And we can get more. There's been cases of overgrowth of teeth, but not with the abundance of a shark. Sharks, on the other hand, have like 2-3 rows of teeth, 2-3 rows of teeth, which is crazy. And those teeth, they fall out all the time because of, you know, their diet. Sharks can eat whatever other fish, they eat seals, you know, other aquatic animals. Have they been known to bite humans? Yes, but on rare occasions. A human is not on the dietary list of a shark. But there have been cases where, you know, shark has attacked humans. That has happened. But the numbers will show that it's not often. Like, it's, no. There are other animals that you got to worry about far greater danger than in the water than a shark. Believe it or not, despite what Hollywood shows you, there are other animals in the water that pose a far greater threat than sharks. Like, I'm reading the, like, if you go to Africa, you're more likely to be attacked by a hippo than a shark. So, you know, sharks aren't looking for trouble. And because of Hollywood, you know, humans have taken it upon themselves to go on a personal crusade against sharks. Even when the data shows that there are far scarier animals in the water to be worried about. Now, are there some aggressive sharks? Yeah, like the bull shark. You know, aptly named because of its personality, very bullish, very aggressive, can be aggressive. But that's just one out of how many species of shark? Sharks there are. Yeah. Now this is going to be very, very intricate here. This is Like I said, this is my most tedious drawing so far. But we're going to see how it goes. If you hear that noise in the background, that's the dog. About to let him outside soon as I'm done with this. Still with the cross-hatching method. Oh, boy. Excuse me. I know people are gonna see this like, this is a shark skull? Yeah, this is one of the many forms that a shark skull takes. Like I said, I would have done the hammerhead shark, which is the most unique shark head there is. Period. But when I looked up the different images for hammerhead shark, I was like, man, I don't think anybody's gonna figure out this is a shark's head. So I stuck with a pretty simple. So many notifications keep going off for things that I don't even pay attention to. But that's all right. I should have turned this thing down. But about to be done soon, so excuse me. Now I'm almost done. I know I said that like 3 times or something. I'm almost done. This stuff is just very, very detailed, very, very intricate and tedious stuff, so pardon moi. Plus, I'd have been here long if I did every single individual tooth of it, of the shark. I've been here all day. And I'm not going to do it. You all get the idea. Sharks have a bunch of teeth. You get the idea. You get the point. Excuse the pun. But I'm not going to do every single tooth now. Just not going to do it. I'm just not going to do it. All right, now I can say I'm done. This is the fourth. All right, thank you all very much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed the little bit of education I brought to you with this. Leave a comment down below. Like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I will catch you all later. Peace.